Wonder what I should carry concealed. Should I go with semi-automatic, revolver, a big gun, small gun? Not sure.
I got you. Beretta ADX Cheetah. Very concealable, great recoil management of 380, capacity fantastic.
Okay.
All right, hold what you got. I hear you. I got 500 reasons of get off your lawn right here.
Okay, this has too much going on with the external safeties, and that's not concealable.
You know what, guys? Let's talk about what we actually carry. It's definitely not that. And hint, 9mm. Welcome back to Class Firearms, guys. Kaya here with Jason.
What's going on, folks?
And we've got Three Gun Kenzie with us.
What's up?
And today we're going to talk about what do we conceal carry and why, and
how.
Where,
and how,
all of that stuff. Mm-hmm. And conceal carry is becoming more mainstream every day, and that's a really good thing. Get out there and exercise your Second Amendment rights. Obviously, proper training, proper equipment together, you're going to have the right conditions to protect yourself and your family. Now, Jason, how long have you been concealed carrying?
Over 10 years, man.
Over 10 years. What about you, Kenzie?
Actually, know my exact anniversary. So my birthday's Sunday, and it'll be 11 years to the day.
All right, so happy birthday in
advance.
So that's good. And I've been since 2011. So it's been how many years? I don't do math.
13
years, right? So, and you know what, guys? It's incredibly important. Seriously, get out there and exercise your Second Amendment rights. Watch a lot of our videos. We do a lot of content when it comes to concealed carry, even home defense stuff. Yeah. So that'll help you tremendously. If you guys have any questions, let us know in the comment section. Maybe we could assist you with further stuff.
And we also preface this by do it legal. Follow your state's laws because that's a big thing. So
absolutely.
Yeah.
We don't advocate anything illegal here. Whether you agree with the laws or you don't, that's a completely different story.
Yep. Yeah.
They're out there, follow the law. That's it, let's move on. So, who should I start with?
Ladies first.
Okay. All right then, Jason.
Okay.
Kenzie.
Okay, so I carry 4 o'clock position. I used to carry appendix. You can mix it up, whatever you're comfortable with, but this works for me. So, I have my IWI, Masada Slim, EPS, Hollow Sun Red Dot Optic, and it's bone stock other than the Cerakote job, because, you know, had to have it colorful. But I do have 2 clips on each side of the holster that I wear, tucked in kind of on the side. And so that's my gun, and it's pretty dirty. Need to clean it, need to oil it. But I do have an enclosed red dot. So that was really important because it's super dirty, guys. So if you're gonna sweat, rain, mud, whatever, I do like an enclosed dot.
And you know what? You get a lot of like little dust and little lint.
Debris, everything. Mm-hmm. Super gross. But yeah, slimline design, so it's really comfortable. I can reach the trigger, I can grip the gun well. And so I really love this gun in 13+1 capacity.
Okay. Yep. So, and you've always carried at the 4 o'clock?
Not always. Like I started with appendix, and I liked appendix. I still like sidecar holsters, but this has just been the most comfortable for what I do. Hiking, backpacking, driving a million miles, mm-hmm. So just whatever. Appendix is super comfortable, but 4 o'clock has just been the change for me.
They all have their pros and cons.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Yeah. So we're not here to just tell you, oh, this is better. They all have. Appendix is faster, but then you're flagging your own self, all of that.
Right.
That's a different topic,
hot
right?
Hot take.
Exactly.
And then
exactly.
a little spare mag, so it's important to have a spare mag. Mm-hmm. This is kind of tucked in. You can do an outside the waistband, you know, mag pouch, or you can do inside. I like inside, but yeah, always have a spare mag.
Yeah.
Really important.
Yeah. I just throw a little spare mag in my pocket, right next to my wallet. It kind of blends in. I just do that. But
yeah.
Very good having a spare mag, because, you know, concealed carry technology. I mean, there's a lot of options out there now.
Yeah.
It used to be just a few guns, and now there's so many of them. And we used to be able to carry, what was that, the Glock 43 with like 6 rounds?
Yep.
Holy crap, okay. Now we've got guns capacity like 15 rounds, like 12, 15,
rounds.
17. It's just, it's so much better. But however, having more ammunition on you, better have it, not need it, and not have it, right?
2 is 1 and 1 is none, and knife people know that. And so gun people, we need to learn that pretty good.
Exactly. That's very good. And you do you carry one in the chamber or you don't?
Oh, yes. 100%.
Okay.
So you plus up. So if I'm unloading my gun, mag comes out and I've got one in the chamber. 100%.
All right.
And then you should always plus up. It's capacity, guys.
Exactly. That's very good. All right, Jason, what do you got?
Well, I normally carry appendix. It's quick for me. Otherwise, let me preface that. It depends on what I'm wearing, right?
That's true.
If I'm in comfortable clothing, I'm not dressed to the nines, I'm not in a suit, or I'm not in like going out clothes, I'll do appendix carry. And, you know, I carry a T-Rex Arms sidecar holster. But here's the thing, I carry a full-size capable gun. So we're talking about a Glock 17 with an Acro, X300, and just some goon tape, little, you know, homemade trigger jaw polish minus connector. It's good. This does the jazz as well. Again, enclosed optic for lint, debris. If I have to, you know, ram it off of something, I know it's going to be good. And that's how I've run it as
and
well.
And you can co-witness too.
I got full co-witness sights on here. So another thing, I normally run this with just a flush mag in there just to get it because I've got this Magwell, this Magpul extended Magwell, the best $12 I ever spent.
Okay.
And then I also run a plus two base pad just to give me that extra round. So
very well
17
equipped.
Plus one and then 19 rounds.
Show them the other side too. Of how you make it comfortable for carrying.
So how I also keep comfortable, I use tier one concealed, use wedges. Mm-hmm. And it actually keeps the gun from digging into your...
gut.
Things. Parts.
So
it hurts.
It does hurt.
Wedges are good.
So another thing with this, with the sidecar, it gives you adjustable cant on how it actually folds to your body. And if I wanted to run this not as a sidecar thing, I could take this off and actually put the clip on here to run it at 4 o'clock or whatever.
Yeah.
And people don't actually know about the claw on this holster as well. What is that for?
So the claw is actually for an adjustment. Well, you have full adjustment on here if you want to cant it one way, cant it another way. But I use this out and push it out so it gives me the most standoff on my belt line to keep this big gun from printing.
You do a good job. I'm impressed.
I mean, it's comfortable. And people are like, oh my God, you carry a 17? I'll carry a 34 in the winter.
That's so, okay. We've been harping on this for a while now, guys. And that is... It really depends on the person.
Yeah.
The size of the person, obviously the way you dress, really depends. So in this case, Jason's a big guy. He's able to carry that thing. He's able to, the way that he wears his t-shirts, whatever he's wearing, he's able to conceal that without really printing all that much. You really can't tell he's got this giant Glock 17.
I wouldn't be able to do it.
Yeah.
With an X300, so I mean, you're talking full length. Yeah. And like I said, I mean, here's a beautiful thing. If you carry a light like this, the length of the slide doesn't really matter.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
So I can carry a 34 easy. So
you said depends on what. What's your secondary position that you know?
Okay, so my secondary position, give or take, on what I use, I actually carry an old school Springfield XDS as more of like my form fitting.
Nine mil.
Yeah. The one that does not say grip zone. Mm-hmm. First of all. Because the reason why, it's actually a really good shooter. It truly is.
I really love it.
I love the little picky extension that it gives you, so you get 8 rounds plus one. That's good. And I carry it just at the 4 o'clock. It looks good in a suit. It looks good everywhere. And it just, you know, regular belt, you're good to go. So,
dude, I mean, speaking of that XDS 9, I carried that for, I think, like 10 years nearly, right? And it, I've never had any issues. I know some people just had their own issues with certain Springfield models, but
I've never had
any issues.
And the gun is a shooter.
Nice, slim gun. Yeah, it's a shooter. It's really good. Yeah. And, dude, I carried the Springfield. Now, let's get to me, right?
Yeah.
I carried it at 4 o'clock all of these years, all right, like 10 years. Well, more like, I guess, 5 o'clock, right around here. Mm-hmm. And I trained a lot, because whatever position you're carrying, you have to train.
Yeah, you have to. Dry fire is definitely.
Yeah, where you're gonna learn everything. 90% of it is dry fire training.
So if you're just, if you're an appendix guy, all right, you're constantly doing appendix, and then one day you wear a suit or whatever, right, and you wanna go 4 o'clock, well, if something happens, your muscle memory is gonna take you up front. You're gonna be startled to find that gun, remember it consciously, and then it may be too late. So make sure you guys definitely train out there. In my case, I've got just an appendix carry. I do lately, in the last, I'd say, 3 years, 2.5, I've been appendix carrying. And now we got the Hellcat Pro Comp. Ooh. I actually did have the Hellcat Pro. Just most recently got the Hellcat Pro Comp because it's brand new, and I switched it. But this is my Hellcat Pro. If you guys notice,
He's very proud of this, guys.
It looks a little bit different, all right? This is personally hand stipple by yours truly.
So send him a DM and he'll...
He did, you guys do.
I'll hook you guys up,
for the
whatever.
Right price?
Of course. Talk to my assistant. So, yeah, I kind of design all of these things because it look cool, and it's much more aggressive. It feels really good. Yep. You know, listen, stippling jobs are very important. It's not just looks because you get, God forbid, blood on your hands. You could be helping somebody out. You could be shot yourself, God forbid, again. Oil.
Rain.
Like it could, sweat, right? So you want something that's gonna keep this gun in your hand, not slide around. That's why I don't like those guns that have like people just paint.
Yeah.
It gets slippery. Guys, you'll have a hard time even racking the slide. So there's that. That's a besides the point.
Especially with the size of it.
Yeah.
Exactly. So exactly. So I've got the good old Hellcat Pro.
That's what the
SMS Shield.
You know, I kind of rack off the dot too much, but.
Yeah. Well, they're supposed to be able to take it, right?
Yeah. Yep.
TLR7 sub right here, an Alpha Omega, inside the waistband. Holster.
Mm-hmm.
So I carry appendix because it's a lot easier. I've trained myself numerous times, just also left hand draw, right hand draw, just single hand draw, because normally you just use one hand, pull your shirt up, and then grab the gun. Sometimes your hand, one of your arms could be out of commission. In fact, a quick insert, like a story, one of the guys that I used to work with a while back, he was just doing his private security, and he just got ambushed by this gangbanger, and he got shot. He was a left-handed guy, right? And the guy ambushes him, the first round hits him right here, and he said, my arm just started flopping because it hit his bone. So he couldn't. So he had to, and he didn't really train left-handed, right-handed, well, off-hand draw. He said he had to somehow figure out a way to get his gun out as he's taking fire, and he got hit here in the leg like multiple times. And he was able to finally get his gun out and return fire, but by then the guy was gone.
And I think this is a good point to mention. If you notice something about that off-hand training and not having your dominant hand, it's a good argument for why I carry a weapon light.
Yeah, of course.
I mean, first of all, I can move this from either side and activate it, and 9 times out of 10, most bad stuff happens at night. You can't shoot what you can't see, so I like to make sure I have PID before I would ever have to engage with my firearm. Just FYI.
Interesting, too, each of us have a different holster setup, so I don't care what brand of holster you love, you know, but he's got a single clip. I have two clips. He's obviously got the flexibility one, two clips, the claw. It needs to be molded to your firearm or your light, whatever you're running, so that's what you notice. Whenever you hear the click, okay, it's coming in. I said that wrong. Whenever you hear the click, it actually is going into the holster. So all of these are molded for the gun, and that's really important.
And I'm a believer in keeping everything tight. Even when I was back years ago on duty, like I'd see these cops just like walking around, like everything is
dangling. Leather holsters,
Even leather, I wore leather, but it needs to be tight.
Whenever
I have this gun on me, this belt is tight. Okay, so when I grab this gun and I remove it, this holster is not moving. It's just tight on my body. So that's very important. That's why the single clip is just doing just fine for me.
So can we all agree Kydex is the way?
Kydex is the way.
Okay.
I'm going to screw this up for the off-body carry for y'all, but
leather, here's the upside for leather, okay? The upside is it's going to be very comfortable. Downside is good luck getting that retention.
Also, con, your trigger's not covered. So, biggest thing for
you. Well, you could have a trigger cover leathers.
It's tough.
You could have, but it's just not going to be.
Kydex.
Kydex is pretty good.
Keep it simple, stupid.
So, there's that. And the thing is, I also want to talk about this little quick training thing. When I carried my XDS, my 5 o'clock, I really like my off hand. It was kind of like, numerous times I tried it. It was extremely hard to get to. So especially if you're one of those like bigger guys or gals or some really big muscular guys that get very limited mobility, it's really hard to get to it. So I like appendix because I can get to it this way. And also, lastly, guys, practice dry practice while you're in your car. Because a lot of things happen while you're sitting at a restaurant.
Especially how to defeat the seatbelt if you're carrying. Big thing.
There's that.
You want to see the off-body.
Okay, so now that we touch base on all these like on-body, like different positions, concealed carry, not all concealed carry positions are on your body. Depending on what you're wearing, depending on who you are, where you're going, we've got some off-body options. Kinsey?
Yep, so I am a big proponent of on-body carry, I will say that. And there are days, literally last night, that I have both guns on me. So that was on me at the 4 o'clock, and then this is my just comfortable bag. The more that you can be hands-free, I don't care if you're a purse girl, whatever, you know, you've got the tactical fanny pack, right, coming back.
Well, if you're James Reeves from TFBTV, you wear a fanny pack because you're James Reeves.
And they're coming back. I see a lot of women doing crossbody, but you do want your hands free. So this is a Vertex bag. I also have a 511 bag that I really like, and inside here, I gotta set it up right, is Velcro. So I keep the actual zippers up top. I'm right-hand dominant, so I use the zipper to pull down. Right hand goes in, grabs gun, comes out of the holster. I've had this gun for so long. It is the Glock 43. When you talk about little baby, 6+ one, like this is it.
I mean, guys. Glock, what were you thinking?
But,
that's it?
Hey, I got
shout
two
out
guys.
The shield arms out there. They actually improve the capacity by 50%. So if it's 6, then you get 9. If it's the Glock 43X, then you get, if it's, what is that, 9 15. to...
15
I think I bought this like the day it came out once it was the big hotness. But inside here, I do use a crossbreed holster. It is molded to the Glock 43 specifically, and you see the Velcro backing. So it's like half leather in the back, and then you've got the Kydex in the front. But same thing when you're locking it in, you do have the trigger is completely covered and it has the proper retention. And then again, like you just saw me set this up, make sure you dry fire, make sure you practice, make sure you have the zippers in the right position, because if you don't, it's completely useless to have.
And, yeah. I will say this, that color does not scream gun.
No, it's so,
let's girly. Talk about that. It's not even that, it screams utility bag. Yeah. It doesn't scream I have a gun in there.
Yeah.
If I'm just, you know, just walking, I probably won't notice that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So that's another thing.
And then backpacking and hiking, like when I have my full pack on me, it's super heavy and it's actually like the waist, you know, has the buckle. So there's no really way to get to your gun. This is really easy to sling in front of me and not say open carry, because I'm not a fan of open carry.
Yeah.
At all. You know what? Just don't do it.
Don't open carry, guys.
In a non-training environment, absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. Exactly. I mean, if you're out there walking around Walmart and around and just like open. Okay.
Yeah.
Let's mention this.
Yep.
What are we going to talk about?
Well, if they go to Rumble.
I get all the links to all the things.
Where?
Freedom. Where? Rumble.com.
No, they go to Classic Firearms and they watch this video and they go to the description of this video and they see some links.
For stuff.
For stuff and things.
For stuff. That's all we're going to say and we're going to move on. All right? So guys, this is what we do. So let us know in the comment section, what do you conceal carry and how? I want to know, and what's your reasoning? Exactly. And where and how? What's your reasoning? And because you know, this is a great example, dude. Like, we got Jason over here, he's carrying a full size gun with an extra mag on it, and he's able to conceal it.
Yeah, I wish I could.
Like, I couldn't do it with my extremely tight shirts.
He's absolutely correct.
If he quit shopping at Baby Gap, you know.
Yes.
But, you know.
And you know what? I'm proud of it.
Yeah.
So, that's why I gotta go with these little baby guns.
You'll love the way you look.
All right? Yeah. I guarantee it.
There's no excuse to not be able to carry these days. Yeah, you can do full size. I think that's amazing. If you can do it, awesome. But the amount of firearms that are out there that are slimline design, able to conceal on the body. We just tested out the Springfield. Nope.
It's Smith & Wesson.
Smith & Wesson.
Just say, we just?
We just actually got to test the bodyguard from Smith & Wesson, and that was tiny. You put it in your shoe.
It fits in my hand.
Exactly. So
no excuses. They're gone.
I agree. And lastly, I want to interject this, guys. When you get out there and train, because you can have all the cool things. If you don't train, it's not going to be good enough. But I'm talking about actual ammo.
Yeah.
All right? You're going to have a carry ammo. That ammo is going to be is going to behave a little bit differently than ball ammo.
Yep.
You know, and the practice gun. Ammo.
Exactly.
You know, one round might not shoot through all these guns.
Yep. Get out there and train with your carry ammo. I understand you can get out there and get a lot of range time with ball ammo. That's fine. It costs cheaper. But make sure, please, train with your carry ammo.
At least the proper grain.
Yeah. Proper grain. Right. Exactly. So, because it's going to, when I say it's going to behave differently, folks who don't know, you're going to have less recoil with a good old 115 or 124 grain ball ammo. And then once you put a plus P, you know,
90 grain. It's hot.
Then it's even hotter. So you're going to have more recoil. So just train with that. And that's all I'm going to say. Guys, check out cfcontest.com. What happens there, Kenzie?
I mean, they are going to be able to have some pretty cool things when they get entered to, you know, I mean, maybe win. So
all these cool things that you
so
see.
Much.
Yeah, they get a feature over there, and you'll thank us later. Yep. So cfcontest.com. Guys, thanks for tuning in. Let us know your comments in the comments section, and we appreciate your business.
God bless.
We'll see you on the next one.